Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and it's time for some of our seeds that we started with our simple seed starter to be transplanted to the next stage before they get moved outside. And mostly right now it's going to be the squash, because they're getting big enough. You can see they have their real leaves now, and it's to the point where they're too big for their container. So we've got blue Hubbard squash and acorn squash that I'm moving today. And I just want to show you, and I'm going to pick up this root, this container, how the roots have really developed already.
That's pretty amazing.
Yes, and these are even larger.
Yeah, so it is time to transplant those.
Yes.
But what about all your other ones that you have here? Like, I know you've got marigolds going in the background.
Right, and I do have some watermelon back here, but you really don't want to move them until they have more of their second leaf on them. As opposed, well, just look at this. You can see the second leaf here, the second leaf. These are just beginning to get a second leaf.
Okay, so it's too early to transplant those.
And all these little ones right here, those are coleus that I planted from seeds. They're going to take a while yet. And some things haven't come up yet either. So,
how about the marigolds?
Marigolds are ready.
Can you put that cover down?
This cover.
Yeah, so I can see them.
Okay.
Thank you.
You can see these are definitely marigolds. They have their second set of leaves. They are ready. They could be moved. They don't have to be moved right this very minute. These really do need to be moved right this very minute.
Okay, so basically you're going to be transplanting
squash.
Seedlings.
Yes, seedling squash for today. Now it's important when you're transplanting from one area to the next that you have markers for each one of them, because this has one marker. I have three plants in here. I'm going to be separating them, and once they're separated, I won't know which one is which unless I have another marker. So I've already made out my little markers. And since I put three in here and I don't want them all in the same pot, I am going to ruin my little planting cup, but it'll be very easy because it's ready to come apart already. And I can easily then move them. I found out yesterday while we were watching someone else's video that it's important that you don't lift them by their stems, because the stems are just too fragile at this point. It's better to lift them by a leaf.
Or a spoon.
Come on. Let go. And I'm just going to break that one. So instead of picking it up like this, I'm going to pick it up like this. And then I'm going to dig a little hole in the middle. Now these are potting soil with more vermiculite mixed in. And once you get it in place, you want to push it down. And
so you want to gently firm it.
Yes. And stick the marker in right away so you remember which is which.
Plus, you've pre-moistened.
I have,
and the soil.
And yet I notice when I dig down deeper, it's dry. So even though I've pre-moistened, it's still not moist enough. I will have to water it again. It up by the stem, not even thinking. It's a messy job, but someone's got to do it. And in goes the marker.
Now this would be the last transplanting stage before getting to that point where you actually start hardening it outside and
Correct.
Getting ready to actually plant it.
Correct.
Ooh, look at those roots.
Now Hubbard squash are very large squash, so their plants are very large and they have big root systems. As you can see by the size of the stems,
They don't mess around. This one actually is a little early to be transplanting this, but I'm going to do it anyway.
So this, you actually started the seeds maybe, what, 2 weeks ago?
Mm-hmm, about 2 weeks ago.
Now, could you have put them in a larger container right to start with so that you wouldn't have to go through this, you know, transplanting stage? Or
I suppose I could have. You never know how many seeds that you plant will actually germinate.
But you could thin them out if you had, let's say, more than two or three growing in a in an area.
You could.
I mean, I kept thinking when we would go to the garden center, sometimes you get a container that has two or three actual plants growing in one pot.
Yes,
is that going to mean you get a healthier display or healthier harvest by having more plants in one area?
I'm not quite sure what you mean.
Well, if you have three plants competing for soil.
Yes.
Nutrients.
Right.
Is it better to have just one plant, or is it better to have a couple of plants in case one doesn't make
it? Oh, yes, yes. You hedge your bets. You have more than one plant.
Yeah.
Which is why I put two and three seeds in each of these little pots. Now, if they hadn't germinated, and some have not, then I've only wasted one container, you know, of soil and time and effort. Mm-hmm. Yep, they are entangled well. There we go. I guess it's your own preference. I mean, if you have,
I suppose if you have the space, then
right.
You start with a larger pot to begin
mm-hmm.
with. Because I would think even these are relatively small pots than
right.
what you might buy at a garden center.
What, 3-inch pot?
Yeah. Because I think with those, you get either a 4 or 5-inch pot once they really mature. But then you're paying, you know, $5, you know, for a container compared to a package of seeds that you start yourself.
Right. And these are our heirloom seeds, so.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how that heirloom package,
so
all those different varieties.
So far, the germinations have been pretty good.
Yeah.
I'll admit. I'm just going to use up this soil that was in the little tubes.
And if you're going to do this, make sure that you, you know.
You're not working on a white tablecloth?
Yeah, yeah. Or in the middle of your living room and getting it all over the carpet.
Mm-hmm.
So then when all the other seeds start to develop, now could you take one of these cardboard containers and go ahead and actually plant that all together in one of these pots where they have more room to develop and grow? Because that cardboard is going to eventually dissolve, right?
Mm-hmm. It does. Right. It just, well, it falls apart and then it decomposes in the soil.
Would you do me a favor and just take one of those and plant it in here just as an experiment?
Let me dig my hole first.
Okay.
I can't believe how dry it is in there.
Yeah.
After all that
watering.
Moisture
my
we put
goodness.
In.
Maybe you could even gently wiggle the cardboard out of there without disturbing the roots too badly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there you go.
Killed one of them, but oh well.
Yeah. I just want to see what happens.
It's just that they're going to be very crowded.
Yeah, well, we'll have to thin them out if it gets to that point.
Okay, so we can do the rest as they get older. Now that I have all the plants that I'm doing today transplanted, there's a couple of things to remember. They will be in shock, unless they were like these that had the little cone still on them. But I'm thinking more the squash that are in the back there and the ones that I had to separate into individual pots. They're going to be in shock because they've been moved. So you have to keep an eye on them. And you have to make sure that if you have them in the house where it's like 70 degrees, perfect temperature, keep them in a bright sunny place. Now that they are green, they need to get the sun so they can start producing sugars for them to grow. Out here, because it's still only in the 40s here, we have to add a little bit of heat during the day. And I don't have the heat on underneath the plants anymore. It's just one of the heating pads that's off to the side. And because this is all closed up and insulated, that'll be warm enough for them until it gets warm enough to be putting them outside to harden them off.
Well, it's a nice little greenhouse to have inside, so to speak, that you can keep an eye on and control, and a great way to start your seeds.
Definitely. Definitely. It's lots of fun, and our grandson comes and he makes sure that he looks in here to see how our plants are doing compared to his plants, because he too made a marigold greenhouse and his plants are growing, and he was saying, well, how are yours doing, Gima? So we'll kind of have a little competition going there.
Well, it's nice to teach young children how to do this as well.
It gets them excited about growing. Then they know where their food comes from and where the flowers are, where the flowers come from. Who knows unless you actually plant them or see somebody else do it.
You know, growing a garden is pretty much like having a dream, because it does take a you have to have an idea of what you're trying to accomplish in life.
Right.
You have to plant some seeds. Well, you have to organize and prepare, first of all, for what you really want.
Right. Get your soil ready.
And then you got to start planting some seeds and getting opportunities out there. And you know, what makes gardening easier is we've seen it happen before. So it's easier to believe that, yes, a garden is possible.
Right. You have to have faith that when the seed is in the ground, it will germinate and sprout and create a plant that will give you flowers or fruit.
And just think of the bountiful harvest you're going to have at the end of it all, with all of that work and effort and energy.
That's right.
Dream big. You know, it takes about the same amount of energy as thinking small.
And if you have too much for yourself with all that bounty, you can always give it to someone else.
Sharing is great.
That's right. Well, if you enjoyed our video, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear your comments and your hints to help us do better. And if you have questions, I'll do my best to answer them, as I do every email and comment that is sent my way. Sometimes it takes me a little longer, but I'll get to you. And if you'd subscribe, we'd be most appreciative.
Yeah. Well, we're also, this is video number 496. Mm-hmm. We're four away from video 500, and I think we're going to have something very special for our viewers. And so stay tuned and stick with us. I think you're going to enjoy it.
Yep. Bye for now.
Well, can I eat any of this?
No.
Not yet, huh?
Not yet.
Okay.
If the parsley were up, you could nibble on parsley.
Okay. No squash, nothing yet?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Have